Very good evening, students. Today I, Tarun sir, your English teacher, would be teaching you the summary of the first chapter of 12th CBSE board, and the first chapter is from the book Flamingo. The title is The Last Lesson. The title is absolutely appropriate and meaningful because in this chapter M. Hamel, who is a French teacher and he is only playing the major role in this chapter, would be delivering his last lesson on the language French. That means he highlights the importance of the language French in this chapter. Now let's jump to the summary of this chapter. What happens is that this chapter is correlated with the German power at one point of time. Germany had captured two states of France, that is Alsace and Lorraine. Mark it, two states of France, that is Alsace and Lorraine. So M. Hamel was a French teacher who was teaching the language French for the past many years in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. Now, when Germany had captured these two states, so what happened? They received a letter from Berlin, and even M. Hamel received a letter to stop teaching French anymore from that day, from the next day itself, so that the language German can be taught in those schools. So now this is this entire story revolves around his last lesson. Let's understand the character sketch of M. Hamel. M. Hamel was a very strict teacher who used to teach the language French. He usually used to carry an iron rod in order to try to create a fear in the minds of students. There is also one more character in this chapter in the name of France, who is a bit of a lenient kind of a student, who escapes school, who misses schools, who does not pay attention towards his language, neither towards his lecture, and he even takes M. Hamel as granted. He hates his strictness. So M. Hamel now has received a letter. On the last day, what happens in the classroom, there are many, many important people who come to attend the lecture of M. Hamel because they knew that from the next day, M. Hamel won't be teaching the language French anymore. France, as usual, his attitude was very negative. He woke up late, and at that day also he reached late to the school. On the way, in the town hall, he found that people were gathered around the notice board, and they were reading something, but he did not pay attention to it. So he has not come to know that today is the last day of M. Hamel in the school of Alsace and Lorraine. So when he reaches to the school, he thinks that M. Hamel would be punishing him, but he was gently asked by M. Hamel to be seated. Franz, when he entered the classroom, he found that there were important people of the village sitting, and he found everyone to be very silent, as if it was a Sunday morning. So still he was not aware that it is his last lesson, or M. Hamel's last lecture. But once he came to know that it is M. Hamel's last day, that is the French teacher's last day, he was very, very shocked, and he was also sad. He started missing his teacher, that from the next day M. Hamel won't be teaching the language French anymore. The lecture that is delivered by M. Hamel on the last day is very important, and this is how you even get questions from this chapter. He was wearing a green coat, which he usually used to wear it on prize distribution ceremonies and important functions of the school. He was dressed in such a manner as if it is not his last day, but he had a lot of confidence that when he knows his language, when he knows the power of his language French, he can survive anywhere. This is what he said to each and everyone. He was a bit upset that the people who were sitting there, the students who were sitting there, they did not pay much attention to their language. He said that the language is a weapon where, with the help of which, you can survive in any part of the world. His last words were, this is one thing very important to be noted, his last words were, "Viva la France." I would like to repeat it. His last words were, "Viva la France," which means long live French. Everyone was sad. M. Hamel was not at all sad because he knew that wherever he would be having the power of his language French. But we saw a feeling of repentfulness in the eyes of Franz, who at that day came to know that he had to pay attention towards his lecture, and even the people sitting out there who failed to even read, write or slides at regular intervals, they used to even fail to speak their own language properly, they realized the importance of this language. So this is how this chapter ends, the last lesson. And the moral of the chapter, I would like to correlate it with the theme. The moral of the chapter is the same, that one needs to know his or her language to a great extent and need to explore it. Thank you so much.